Hangout is live on the air. Hi, everybody. Shawn M. Miller. Welcome to a special Friday edition of the Shawn Miller Show. Keep watching to find out why it is critical for entrepreneurs to make a prosperity power shift in all aspects of their lives, or you're just destined to remain stuck where you are. This is a special Friday edition. Normal Shawn Miller Show, fast, though. But today I have a special guest. I met this guy, Matthew Miglin, and I met him at a very exclusive high-end event in Canada. And this guy is really, really sharp. He's got a ton of business experience and some really interesting perspective. And so I wanted to get him on the show. So I said, hey, can I get you on the show just for a few minutes? Can you fit it in your schedule and share, you know, some of your key principles with our viewers? And he agreed. So here we are. And Matthew, I probably brutalized that intro, but can we hear you, and can you give us your best, your kind of 30-second pitch about who you are and where you're from?
Absolutely, Shawn. Hey, thanks. And that was a great intro. I'm Matthew David Miglin, and from Newton, New Jersey. And I've been an entrepreneur, kind of a serial entrepreneur, actually, for all the businesses I've been in over 30 years. And one of the things that I've really found is most entrepreneurs and some people who've tried businesses haven't figured it out yet. You know, it seems like 80% or more are still doing it the old-fashioned way, and they haven't made some changes that they need to change. So I'm out here as a business coach these days, you know, business mentor, really trying to help people, you know, change their businesses around. And especially as a money strategist, I really help people really get their finances in order, their profits in order, be able to actually build some wealth. You know, if you're making all this effort in your business and your money's not working for you, you're wasting your time. So kind of excited about being here today and talking.
Right. Well, as you can see, welcome to my Shark Tank. don't let him scare you. He's harmless, but he is intimidating. Well, that's really, really important, and you're starting to make a great point already, and I want to bring that out. So welcome to the Shark Tank now. So tell me, what this prosperity power shift that you were telling me about, why is that so important for an entrepreneur? What is that, and why is that so important? What does it mean for people?
Well, Shawn, it's not just for entrepreneurs. It's actually every single person in some area of their life can use a power shift. And the prosperity power shift is just, it's getting your life shifted from where you are right now to a different place. Because here's what happens. If people, they sometimes make a decision, or they'll think about something they're considering, or they'll set a goal for something, and they never quite attain it, or they never quite get there. And you know why? Because they didn't make a drastic, dramatic shift in their life so that they can make that happen. And so what I found, especially with entrepreneurs, we get in a comfort zone and we get comfortable with business as usual. And we don't know how to get ourselves to that next level so that we know we're doubling our business or tripling our business or doing 10 times the business we are. In order to do that, you have to make a drastic change from where you are currently. So a prosperity power shift, Shawn, it is something where you make such drastic changes in your day-to-day operations that you can't help but have positive outcomes. Now, sometimes, you'll have a few stumbles, but that's part of the process. But a power shift is what everybody needs to make, and until you do that and get out of your comfort zone and get into a place that you're completely uncomfortable, you'll never attain the level of success, profits, and income that you're looking to attain.
Good. Yeah, I'm reminded of a flash. One of my key business mentors, Glenn Dietzel, and he said that every new level in business requires a new you. And I just kind of reminded of that. So, in the Shark Tank here, some folks are a little bit skeptical, and they'll say, okay, Matthew, who gives you the right to tell me how to make a power shift? What's your deal, man? Why are you qualified to speak about this?
Well, first really power shift took place in when I was 18 years old in the United States Marine Corps boot camp, and that's where I went from one one lifestyle to a drastic other lifestyle. And you know how they did it? They did it in 11 weeks and 3 days. And you know what? That is a drastic, dramatic shift from one perspective to a complete other perspective, totally out of my comfort zone, but then into what would be, we would call the elite, the best of the best. in our military, being a United States Marine. That's where it started. And so I took those principles of leadership and all the training that I learned there as a leader that definitely works in every other area of life. It works in your physical, you know, how you take care of yourself. I mean, I'm going to be 50 years old, and I'm in as good a shape as I was when I was in my 20s. Why? Because I took some drastic measures to make sure I stayed in shape. I took some drastic measures in my health after I experienced a heart attack at 46. You know what? Those require some drastic power shifts in your life. And so my business, the ways my business has become as successful as I did, I had to get out of my comfort zone. And, you know, sometimes, Shawn, it's often just one power shift away from where we want to be. Sometimes we're two. Sometimes one's not enough. But generally, it's one power shift that gets us out of that comfort zone, something that we've been so used to for so long. And I'll talk to entrepreneurs who've been in business 20, 30 years, sometimes 40 years, and they've been doing it the same way for so long. They need a drastic power shift in order to obtain the dreams that they've been dreaming about for all their life.
Okay, all right, I'll buy that. So you've got a formula for this. You've proven it, and you've used it in different areas of your life. How does it, I mean, we've got, like, you know, short time, but how does it work?
Well, it's a kind of a combination of systems and formulas and kind of a step-by-step strategy that I take people through. It's not something that you can do in one sitting, but the idea, and I'll give you the brief synopsis of it, is to take and put down where you are right now, the current, where you currently are, and what are your current actions, and what are you doing, you know, let's say for business in this case, what are you doing for marketing wise for your business? What are the formulas? What are the things that you're doing now? And then we say, okay, what could it be, or what should it be? And we create that list, and we say, okay, let's compare side by side. This is where you are marketing and your business and your lead generation, and here's where you should be. Okay, what's that going to require? It's going to require a power shift change in your marketing. So we'll call it a marketing power shift change in this case for a business. And so we say, okay, what do we have to do to make such a drastic change that it's going to stick? It's not going to be temporary. It's not going to fall back into your own comfort zone. What's going to cause you to step out, make a commitment, and get you the success you're looking for by making that drastic change? That's the way I can simplify it the most, but there is a lot of steps to it, but it is basically putting together all the little points of whatever area we're focusing on initially to power shift and make that drastic change.
Okay. Well, and you're not all about business. I get that. Yeah. The show is pretty focused on business, though. The viewers of the show we're kind of a bunch of business nerds. So, what is a mistake that you see an entrepreneur making that's related to your subject expertise?
Oh boy, there is so many of them. I'm going to use the money side, because I'm known as a money strategist because I've studied finance for so many years. I was a financial analyst for 8 years at one point, and so I've helped a lot of people. In fact, probably the area I help the people in the most is their money area. And one of the things that's just really common mistake is not letting your money work for you while you're working. So many people are trying to generate all their income strictly from their own effort, their job, or their business, instead of allowing your money to work for you. What a mistake. You can have your money working 24/7 when you're sleeping, when you're succeeding or not succeeding, and still making some amazing amount of money in addition to it. The other side of that is going with the group, we're going with the crowds. This is probably the biggest mistake I see for average American. They're constantly following the crowd. They're following the stock that's, you know, taken off right now. They're following what the news medias are saying, instead of doing what the rich have done for years. The rich invest and do things with their money completely different from everyone else, and they value every dollar. I mean, it's funny how when I talk to people, they say, well, that's only 20 bucks, or that's only 50 bucks, or 100 bucks, and they don't realize that $50 or $100 they're treating as insignificant can drastically change their financial future. So whether it be for their business or for their personal wealth creation, they make these mistakes by not learning what the rich do and making a drastic change. It's so different from what the average American does. It's night and day.
Nice. I'm reminded of the phrase that lacking clear direction, just see what everybody else is doing and do the opposite.
It's true.
I think I heard that first from Dan Kennedy, but
J. Paul Getty said that all the time: buy when other people are selling, and sell when everybody else is buying.
Right. So you're obviously advising people, and they're obviously coming to you with questions in this area, and as part of your mentoring process that you do. What's the question, Matthew, that they don't ask that they should? You know, what's the real heart of the matter that they're just not asking?
Well, I'll give you a great example, and people could tie this in with a lot of things, but when someone's trying to find, in this case, a financial advisor or someone who's going to be a stockbroker or any kind of investment manager for them, the one thing, and actually anything someone's selling you, for that matter, it doesn't even have to be financial, but this is one thing I'll say all the time, is like, the one question you are not asking is, show me your portfolio and show me this stock or this mutual fund or whatever it is you're selling. Show me how much of it you own. And you will be shocked that the mass majority, I would say 92% or more, do not own the very thing that they're selling. And if you invest in them, you are making a huge mistake. Same thing when the guy who's the salesman at the car dealership is trying to sell you this car. The first question I ask is, What kind of car do you drive? And if they don't drive that brand, it's like, well, you must not really believe in as much as you say here, as you're saying. So the idea is to challenge everyone who's selling you something to see if they believe it enough that they're using the product, that they own the product, and especially when it comes to your money, because nobody's going to take care of your money as good as you are. So why would you entrust it to somebody who doesn't believe in the product that they're selling to have you put your money in as much as you do? If they're not invested in it, it's, like they're telling you to, then how much faith can you really have in them? So just ask that question for whatever it is that you're somebody's selling you.
That sounds like a good vetting process. I'll bet that will vet out. I'm a big a proponent of vetting salespeople and vetting people who want access to me, and that certainly sounds like a great vetting process.
So, let me add one more thing to it, Shawn. Too is they always say is don't invest in somebody who doesn't have more net worth than you have as well. It's like let me show your portfolio. If they're not as wealthy as you are or more, they're not the person you want to be listening to. I always say it this way: they call the financial brokers because most of them are broke.
That's fair. Good. So last thing, and we'll kind of wind down here. We got a lot of great things to do on a beautiful Friday. So what's the action step that you're advising our viewers to take? Matthew, what should they do now?
Well, it's pretty simple. Is they need to and my audience a lot of times is primarily people in their own business, entrepreneurs and all that. So I'm going to talk a little bit about that. The action step, the kind of thing that they need to be applying to their lives, they need to get a business plan together. Now, if your business is not where you want it to be, if your income's not where it needs to be, you need to get a plan together. Obviously, what you're doing is not working. And here's one thing I'll preface before I finish that point is business today is not what it used to be. What we experienced for the last, 15 years was an economy that was not realistic. People were pulling money out of their retirement accounts, out of their homes, all the equity and all that. And so we had this abundance of wealth that was poured into the economy that was not realistic. And we may not see that again for another 25 or 30 years. So business as usual is not the way it used to be. Business as usual means you're going to have to work. You're going to have to do things that businesses didn't have to do for the last 20 years, and now you're going to have to. So having said that, your business is on the decline for the most part. Most businesses I talk to, they're either declining or they're completely stagnant. Very few are growing. And so you need to put a plan together because your current plan is not working. You need to put a plan together that is going to set you in a position so that you're going to be more successful and you're going to be able to monetize what you're doing. So that thing means putting the plan together, put the steps of action, things that you're going to begin to do even as early as next week that you can start to do to put a plan together. Now, sometimes we're used to doing things the same way over and over again. So here's the problem. We're going to probably create a plan that's very similar to our previous plan because we only think linear most of the time in one way. So what does that mean? There's very few, there are exceptions, but very few people that can succeed on their own. We all need someone. And I've gone through, you know, I list sometimes, I say, well, everyone from Jesus Christ to the disciples to you know, Tiger Woods to Arnold Palmer and all these great golfers, Michael Jordan, they all had coaches and mentors. Matter of fact, Tiger Woods has had as many as 3 coaches recently, you know, to make, now you're saying this guy was number one in the world. Why would he need 3 coaches? Because they're helping him go farther than he's able to make himself go himself. Same with Olympic athletes. They need a coach because they can go so far, but it's that coach that'll push them that extra distance. They'll be able to give them a little extra tip to make them that much better. And so for you in business, if you want to get your business to an not just a little bit more, 5 or 10% more business, why not double or triple your business? But you're not going to be able to do that with the knowledge you have today. You need additional knowledge, and you need insight and wisdom from somebody who knows, who's been there, who maybe they'll tell you something that you can't see, that we're typically blind in our own lives and businesses to the very things that are under our noses, and we need somebody to point it out and show us. So if I could say anything, it's putting a new plan together, get ready to put action to it, and find somebody who can help you make that plan work and be effective at it. So find a coach, a mentor, find someone who can help you go to that next level, because without it, I don't believe you'll ever reach the level of success you desire or you're capable of without somebody helping you.
All right. Thank you, Matthew. That's good. How do people reach you if they want to follow up and connect with you after they see this? How do they find you?
Well, they can certainly find me on LinkedIn, LinkedIn with Matthew Miglin. Also my website, MatthewDavidMiglin, MIGLIN.com. That's my main website, products, all kinds of things, you know, on there. But you can contact me through either that or even find me on Facebook if you need be. But anyway, that's they can find me all those places.
All right. Well, we're going to wrap it up for today and head out. I have one actionable for you, David, and for the Matthew and for the viewers. I want you to take a quick stop by SeanMMiller.com and try out the Celebrity Predictability Index. We've been working really hard on it, and we've got the model for you exactly where you're at on your path from today to that real celebrity authority position. I'd love to have you take that a shot. So log on to SeanMMiller.com and give a try of the Celebrity Predictability Index and let me know how that works for you. Thanks, everybody. Thank you so much to Matthew Miglin for joining us. Thanks to all of the viewers all over the world. We're thrilled that you could join us, and everybody have a great, great day. We're out for today. See ya.
Thanks.